opportunity to share your word one more time with your congregation. We ask, Lord God, that you move Phyllis out of the way. You take control by your spirit, God. That you will teach your people what they need to know and what they believe about Jesus Christ. So, Father, we thank you, Lord, for souls that will be encouraged and strengthened and saved through your word on this day. What is in Jesus Christ's name?
Of Galilee. Right. was asleep on a pillow in the stern of the boat. When a windstorm arose and began, by the water began to cover the boat over. In fear, his apostles woke him up and asked him, "Don't you care that we're going to drown?" Jesus got up and ordered the wind to be quiet. The wind stopped and everything was calm. Jesus asked them, "Don't you have any faith?" They were more afraid then than before as they asked one another, "Who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him." After Jesus and his apostles crossed the Lake of Galilee to the region of the Gerasenes, where they encountered a man secluded in the tombs who could not be chained. As he walked through the tombs and hills, he would constantly cry out, hardly cutting himself with stones because he was possessed by a demon. Then Jesus and his apostles crossed over. After Jesus called the demon out of him, they crossed over to the other side of the lake. And Jairus, the leader of the synagogue, begged Jesus to come and put his hands on his daughter to heal her. As they were walking to Jairus' house, a woman who had been bleeding for 13 years stooped down and touched the hem of his garment while she was on her knees in the crowd. She was instantly healed by her faith. But when they got to Jairus' house, Jesus entered her room alone. Jesus later healed a deaf and mute man, cast out a demon of a demon-possessed Syrophoenician woman's daughter, healed a deaf and mute man, and fed 4,000 people with 7 loaves of bread. The apostles traveled with Jesus, being taught together by themselves and with him as well as with the crowd, witnessing the miracles of Jesus. When Jesus went to the villages around Caesarea Philippi, he asked them, "Who do people say that I am?" Jesus had come to a point, I believe, in his ministry where he had done all of the miracles, many more than what are in the scriptures. And he was at a point where he knew he was getting ready to go to the cross of Calvary. So he needed to get, for the apostles he had selected, to get a clear understanding of just who he was. And the apostles answered, "Some say you're John the Baptist. Others say you're Elijah, one of the major prophets. And still others say you're one of the prophets." Jesus then asked them, "But what about you? Who do you say I am?" We tend in our lifestyle with one another to always be concerned about what other people think about us or think about what we're about. And I believe Jesus was stepping them from what people thought to really what they were thinking. And we know from our studies in church school and pastor's Bible study that the Pharisees and the Sadducees did not believe in Jesus Christ. They thought he was a false teacher. And they didn't believe he was sent by God. Because at one point they called him Satan, the devil, Beelzebub. But Jesus knew exactly who he was. He knew who sent him, and he knew what his mission was all about. So he was not confused at any time, regardless of what he encountered with the leadership of that day. But even in our day and time, we know we can all agree. The news media, Hollywood, articles we read, things people say to us, let us know that there's a mixed up thought, even today, about who Jesus Christ really is.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Jesus, when he asked him, who do you say I am? Peter answered, I believe he was answering for the crowd. You are the Christ, the Messiah of God, the anointed one of God.
Yeah.
And that means that God himself, God the Father, when he decided it was the right time, sent Jesus Christ down from heaven and allowed him to be born of a woman. He already existed.
Yes.
He didn't begin to exist when Mary, she was consumed in Mary's womb, his mother's womb. But he always existed in heaven with God the Father and God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We do believe as Christians that we do believe in the tri-trinity of God,
yes,
the triunity of God,
yes,
that God is God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
So when Jesus Christ was born, he knew even as a baby what his mission was. He grew up like the other children,
yes,
but he knew when he came on earth what his mission for this earth was. He came to die for the sins of the whole world.
Amen.
He didn't come to be a good teacher.
Right.
Yes, he was the best teacher.
Yeah.
When he taught in the synagogues, the synagogue leaders would say, we never heard anyone teach like him. Who is this man?
Yeah.
We know he's Mary's baby, a carpenter's son.
Yeah.
But how can he be teaching like this? He taught like that because he was God.
Yeah.
But Jesus said, when you've seen me, you've seen the Father.
Yeah.
I am the Father and one.
Yeah.
So some religion would say, has said that woman told me one day as I was in the street traveling, when I asked her, what do you believe about Jesus? She kept talking. I said, what else do you believe? He's a duplicate. I stood there, I was waiting for my transportation. Wow. I said, I looked up and I said, I said, no, he's the original. And so as we come into contact with false teaching about Jesus Christ is, we have to know for ourselves who Jesus Christ really is. And in order to know that, we have to get in where? In the Word, the Bible, the B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God. The B-I-B-L-E, Bible. And so as we hear all of these things and see different tracks, there's a new set of tracks that are out there that have a wrong idea of who Jesus Christ is. They're not Christian tracks. When I started, I picked them up at a store when I used to have them. I was given one some of these tracks by Sister Barbara Kennedy. Someone had put them on her car one night when we were here in the church. I said, let me read these tracks. Let me look at where they come from.
Yeah.
Foreign countries.
Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah. Still have them because I'm going to teach you on them one Wednesday. Foreign countries.
All right.
Global ministry that's not Christian, placing those tracks all around in the neighborhoods. All around.
Amen.
And if we're not certain about what we believe about who Jesus Christ is, we will get caught up in a wrong idea of who he is. Jesus had performed many miracles. Many more than what we see in Scripture. And Jesus wanted to give everyone who came into contact with him, a definite understanding of who he is. So even as we go through our challenges in our life and circumstances that come up in our lives and broken relationships, issues with children, issues with our jobs, in between a job here and in between a job there, knowing that we are able to stand in Jesus Christ,
right,
only if we know exactly who Jesus Christ is.
Yeah.
If not, we will have a distorted view.
Amen.
That the world has. And we will begin to repeat what the world says about Jesus Christ, because we're really shoulder. Jesus said, I came and I have a ministry. My ministry is to preach the gospel about myself, that others that hear about me will receive everlasting life.
Amen. Thank you.
They will repent and they will become members of the kingdom of heaven, which now has become near to you.
Yeah.
So when we look, if you're traveling with me, turn in your Bible, New Testament, the Gospel of John, chapter 20. I'm going to read verses 30 and 31. And the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 30 and 31. This in your notes. I hope you're taking notes. So you'll be able to go over during the week, you can refresh yourself, and to remember what God is saying to us even today. The Gospel of John, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, chapter 20, verses 30 and 31. Jesus performed many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not recorded in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is who?
Christ.
The Messiah, the anointed one of God, the Christ of God, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have what?
Life
in his name.
Amen.
So there is not life in any other name. But the name of Jesus Christ. We can believe in Buddha. We can believe in the Prophet Muhammad. We can believe in a whole lot of other people. But it's not the prophets. It's not the priests. It's no one else but Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Who is the one who came down from heaven and died on an old rugged cross to give us an opportunity and a privilege to be able to become children of the Most High God. It's not by our works. It's not by our family name. It's not by our attendance at Mount Pisgah or any other congregation. It's not by our tithes and offerings. It's by faith, believing in who Jesus Christ is. Jesus Christ is God in the flesh. He is not a lesser God or a created God. He is the eternal God who came knowing that he was going to die. But he chose to die anyhow. But when he died, the scripture said, he stayed in the grave 3 days. Because that's what the prophet said would happen. And on the third day, no one moved his body anywhere. But on the third day, he arose from the grave and he ascended into heaven. And he said, I will come back again as we prepare for his return. Who is this Jesus, the Christ, the Messiah of God? Turn in your Bibles, write this down. Isaiah chapter 9.
Amen.
Prophesied about our Messiah.
Amen.
Isaiah chapter 9. Everything is proven by scripture, not by what we say.
All right.
Lord, what does your word say? Let's look at verses Isaiah, Old Testament prophet, chapter 9. Let's look at verse 6 and 7. Amen. Isaiah chapter 9, verses 6 and 7. For to us a child is born. To us, a son is given. And the government will will be on his shoulders.
Yeah.
And he will be called Wonderful,
yes.
Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding with justice and righteousness from that time on. And how long? Forever. The word of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. And so then when we look at the question, what do I believe about Jesus Christ? We have to move from what we hear to what we understand, to have a reason to believe. We move from our hearing and understanding to accepting, which means to agree, to trust the truth about Jesus, to accept Jesus as Savior, as Lord of our lives forever. When we move from that point, we begin to realize that we don't just think about Jesus, we don't just acknowledge who he is, but we begin to worship and to praise and to adore Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because he is God in the flesh.
Yeah.
And so when, as we move, we're moving according to how we submit ourselves to the will of God.
Amen.
How we submit ourselves and allow ourselves to be under the authority of God and to be under the authority of the Holy Spirit of God,
Amen.
The third person of the Trinity.
Yes.
And so we can sit in Mount Pisgah every Sunday morning.
Well,
and we can hear sermon after sermon and come to church school and come to pastor's Bible study week after week. But if we don't continue to submit ourselves to the will of Almighty God, coming under God's authority and allowing the Holy Spirit of God to immerse us in him, to continue to pour himself in us, then we will still be at point A. We will still be at the beginning of our relationship.
Yeah.
And God says, I don't want you to stay at point A,
Amen.
My child. I want you to move along in the relationship.
Yeah.
Because as we move along, we will see the awesomeness of God.
Yeah.
We will be humbled by the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
To know that he loved us so much
yeah.
that for a season he gave up his home in heaven. And came down to earth to become a human being. He always existed.
Amen.
Allowed himself to go through a trial, a trumped up trial. And to carry a cross to Golgotha. And to be nailed to the cross, hands and feet, thorns in his head. Just for us. Jesus said, and I have everything in my word. I am the word made flesh.
Yeah, right. Amen.
And everything about me is correct in the word.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said, but you don't want to read my word to find out about me. You just want to dress up and come in and have rehearsals and meetings and dinners and all of that. And you still don't know enough about me to worship and praise and obey and serve me in the spirit of holiness and righteousness. Jesus is asking us today, who do you say I am? Are we saying he's just a good teacher? Are we saying that he is only one of the prophets, major or minor, but still prophet? The words say he's prophet, priest, and king, as well as God. When he gave up his life on the cross of Calvary, the veil of the temple was ripped from, torn from top to bottom.
Amen.
Enabling us not to have to come in and worship him with the priest, with our animal sacrifices. But we can come in freely into the presence of God. Because the blood of Jesus Christ has washed us, cleansed us, and enabled us to stand in the presence of a holy and a righteous God.
Thank you.
And so if we begin to understand, have a correct understanding of who Jesus Christ is, we will sing to him, "My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. All the ground is sinking sand." And we sing it again. All of the ground is sinking sand. Who are we trusting in today? Who are we believing in today? Who are we following today? Jesus said, when I come back, I'm looking for those. I'm coming back for those who have a correct understanding of who I am. He's not coming back for folk with distorted ideas. He's coming back for those who have confessed their faith and their love in the Lord Jesus Christ, in him alone.
Amen.
He will allow us to stand faultless before his throne.
Yes.
He will allow us to bow and prostrate in his presence.
Yes.
And give him honor and give him glory.
Yes.
He is the Messiah of God. He is the anointed one of God.
Yes.
He is the Son of the living God.
Yes.
He is God and God alone.
Yes.
He's the lily of the valley.
Yes.
protect you from the enemy. When you're walking to and fro, my spirit protects you from the evil. Satan is real, you know. He is destroying families, even in the church. Because we don't understand who Jesus is, who God the Father is, who the Holy Spirit of God is. When we come into the family of God, God says, I want to begin to teach you, to correct you, to reshape you, to allow you to walk with me for the rest of your life. If we have a clue who Jesus is, we will hold out our hand and walk with Jesus.
Amen.
Just a little closer walk with me. Another hymn of the church. For everything we need, there's a hymn of the church to cover.
Amen.
Mercy. And some.
Mercy.
So the question comes up again. Who do you say I am? You might be here today and you've never given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. You might have heard a lot about it and talked about it with this person and that person, all of that. But that's on the fringe. But there has to be a relationship. We are born sinners, separated from God. God sent his son to die in our place so we can have a relationship with him, a holy and a righteous God. When we believe that we're a sinner separated from God, when we confess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior and ask Jesus Christ to come into our lives, God then at that very moment dispatches the third person of the Trinity, the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
He is God also. No less than God. Holy Spirit of God.
Amen.
To live on the inside of us, and he teaches us about God. He protects us. He corrects us. Everything that we need, the Holy Spirit is able to provide. But it begins with a confession of Jesus Christ, what we believe about Jesus Christ. So if you're here today and you've never accepted him as Lord and Savior of your life,